Studied about we begin with the photosynthesis and we did the structure of leaf and something about stomata, how did it work, and some theories regarding the opening and mechanism of the stomata, about closing and opening. Okay, so today, what we are going to study is about the process, how the photosynthesis, the whole process occurs, and what are the important reactions in it, and what are the factors affecting it. Okay, so let's begin with this part. This part is clear to you?
Yes, miss.
Okay, fine. So basically,
yes, ma'am.
Okay, so the process of photosynthesis. So the first important thing about this process is that this process is mainly responsible for the production of glucose, and later on that glucose should be converted into starch. Okay, and last time you asked me that, ma'am, whatever glucose is prepared or starch is prepared by the leaf, is it stored over there or not? That also we will be discussing today. It has some another theory also. Okay, so first let's see what is the process of photosynthesis takes on it. Is that we know that plants utilizes carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. Okay, they are the only organisms on the earth which utilizes CO2 for their physiological process. Okay, so with this carbon dioxide, they need little amount of water also. Okay, so only these two key ingredients from the environment they are utilizing, and then the presence of sunlight is compulsory. Okay, because this is the only external factor which is just triggering this reaction. Okay, so sunlight should be there. Then you need a chlorophyll for this. So these four things are the necessity: carbon dioxide, water molecules, and sunlight and chlorophyll, which will help in the synthesis of C6H12O6. Okay, so C6H12O6 is nothing but glucose. Okay. And glucose is formed when again water is also formed and oxygen is released. Okay, so these are the products formed due to this process of photosynthesis. So let's see, when CO2 and H2O combines to give glucose, then it's not always only one molecule of CO2 is taking part. Okay, so we need six molecules of carbon dioxide. Okay, and 12 molecules of water, then only this process will start to balance the reaction. Okay, so six molecules of carbon dioxide, 12 molecules of H2O, will give the products like glucose, water, and oxygen. So now see that you, after completion of this reaction, the one which it is releasing is 6 molecules of oxygen you are getting in turn. That means whatever the number it is utilizing for CO2, that much amount of oxygen is being released by this. Then what you are getting again is that H2O molecules. Okay, so 6 water molecules are also given back. Now see, you must be thinking that out of 12, 6 are coming back. It's not so simple. It's not that simple for this, because this oxygen, the one which you are getting, is from CO2. It's not from this one. Is it clear?
Yes, miss.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So, the oxygen in this water molecule is obtained from carbon dioxide. So, it is actually reformed. This molecule is reformed with this reaction. Okay. So, and this oxygen, the one you obtain in the environment with the help of this reaction, is obtained from this one. So let's make it simple for this, that this oxygen is here, okay, while this one is here. Is it clear now?
Yes, miss.
Okay, so this is what the importance of oxygen molecule in the process of photosynthesis. And then you have glucose, the key ingredient, because ultimately with the help of photosynthesis, what the plants have to prepare is nothing but a food for everybody, for themselves also, for other living creatures also. So the glucose is formed, and later on the glucose has to be converted into starch. That means polymer of glucose. Starch is nothing but the polymer of glucose. It's a complex one. Okay. So then glucose molecules are formed. Now once this is happening, this process is takes two types of reactions. One is light phase and another one is dark phase. Okay. Now see this light phase is also called photochemical phase. This reaction is also known as photochemical reaction, and the location for this is nothing but the grana, or I think in your textbook it is written thylakoids. Okay, but do remember that in higher plants, thylakoids is basically for the lower group of organisms. Okay. While in higher plants, in mature plants, it has to be grana in which this reaction takes place. That means you should have a stack of thylakoids, then only this reaction will occur, because chlorophyll is present somewhere here. Like this. Is it clear to you?
Yes, miss.
Okay, fine. And in this dark phase, the location is nothing but the stroma, the fluid present in the chloroplast. Okay. So location, if somebody asks you the location of process of photosynthesis, then it should be, answer should be the chloroplast. Okay. But if they ask you particular reaction, then you have to mention that it should be in granum, or it should be dark phase, it should be in stroma of the chloroplast. Okay. Now, how these reactions have, the very important one is that the light phase is dependent on light. That means without light, this process is not able to proceed. So it is very much important. While dark phase is, here we will not use the word day or night. It's a wrong term to use. So light should be, light phase should have dependent on light, while dark phase is independent of light. That means it occurs in daytime also. Okay, it occurs in the daytime, but it doesn't require the light for its the continuation. It continues with on its own. Okay, light doesn't makes any other change in it. So what this reaction is having two important steps. First is activation of chlorophyll. Now see, once you come up with the in class 11, if you go for this particular topic, then you have lot more details that how the activation of chlorophyll occurs. But here what you have to understand that this chlorophyll, which is present on the granum stalk, it is activated by, suppose, let me draw it like this, that chlorophyll is a molecule-like structure. It is also a complex molecule. Chlorophyll is a complex molecule. Understood? And this particular molecule is activated by the photons. Photons are nothing but the smallest unit of light. Okay. So smallest unit of light is required to activate the chlorophyll. It absorbs photons from the environment, from the sunlight, and it gets activated to perform this reaction. Okay. And then what happens is, once it is activated, then lot of reactions will occur. And another important reaction for this is, and listen, this part of chlorophyll, the one which is getting activated by the photon, if you read some other books, then you will find this term, photosystem. Okay. Photosystems are there. Those molecules are only getting affected by the light in the chlorophyll. Not more than this is required for you right now. Then next reaction is called splitting of H2, or you can use the term photolysis of water. Okay, so lysis itself means breaking down. And with the help of light, photo means light. So you are breaking down the water molecule with the help of light. That's why this reaction is called photolysis of water. Now what happens when the water molecule is breaking down over here is that H2O. It's not like always a single molecule, but to keep the reaction balanced, we will utilize two water molecules over here. Okay, so two water molecules will give us four hydrogen ions, okay, and plus four electrons, plus it will give us oxygen. Now you have understood how this O2 is obtained?
Yes, miss.
Okay, so this is the molecular oxygen you are obtaining when the water molecule is broken down with the help of light. Now, what happened with this, all these things, the one you are obtaining? This one is definitely is released in the environment for our purpose of respiration. While what is happening with all these things, then let's see that these 4H plus ions are activating NADP, okay? Nicotinamide adenine diphosphate. Okay, so NADP is activated and it is converted to NADPH. Okay, so this is formed. And why it is formed? Just understand that it is a very important molecule which is responsible for the production of energy in the plants and I think in all the living molecules. Okay, so why is it so? That part you will understand once you will understanding reading that respiration molecular or cellular respiration topic in detail. Then you will understand why this NADPH is so much important. And these electrons are, what they are doing is ADP, adenine diphosphate, is converted to ATP. Because electrons have energy in them, this energy is passed to ADP. And once ADP is charged, then the organelle have lot of inorganic phosphate with it. I will mention it like this, P and a small I, sorry, can you see this?
Yes,
ma'am. Just let me know if it is out of screen. Okay, so PI is nothing but the inorganic phosphate. It is already present in the this organelle. So that is to be utilized to make ATP, adenine triphosphate. I think you are all, you both are clear with this a full form of this, di, tri.
Yes, miss.
Okay, so this is how this particular reaction, whatever it is giving out, it should be utilized in the cell. Now, once this is formed, then the process of this, whenever the phosphate is added, we are adding the phosphate to this particular molecule, then that process is called phosphorylation. Now understand, whenever there is a suffix like A-T-I-O-N, ation, that means you are adding something. Okay, so phosphorylation, what you are adding over here, it is nothing but inorganic phosphate is being added to ADP utilizing some of the electrons so that it will get charged and it will be full of energy. And as it is utilizing light, we will use this photophosphorylation. This is very important because phosphorylation process is also occurring in other organelle too. I think mitochondria you have heard.
No, miss. About phosphorylation is the first time.
Okay, phosphorylation you are learning right now. But have you heard about the mitochondria, the cell organelle present in our body?
Yes, sir.
Okay, in a cell. In that, phosphorylation process is going on. So there, light is not involved. So that process is only a phosphorylation. But here, what will you be utilizing? Photophosphorylation. That means with the help of light, it is adding a phosphate to the ADP molecule. Now, understand this, that adenine triphosphate. Adenine is a sugar with 5 carbon. Okay. So, it has a sugar with 5 carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Can you see this? Am I writing? It's too small for you to understand. Shall I make it big? Is it clear?
Yes, miss.
Okay. So, it's a 5-carbon sugar and triphosphate, that means it have phosphates linked to it like this. 3 phosphates. Okay. This is just to make you understand that how ATP is formed. Then once when it is diphosphate, then it has only 2 phosphates with it. The one more phosphate is being added, then it should be adenine triphosphate. If only 1 phosphate is there, then it should be AMP. Adenine monophosphate. Okay? Mono, di, tri. It belongs to the number of the phosphate present in them. Okay. So I think you must be knowing about ATP, that it is an energy molecule. Whenever you require energy, it is released from the ATP in our body. Same thing happens in the plants too. Whenever they require energy, they obtain it from the ATP. Understood?
Yes, miss.
Okay. So, how it will release energy, that is also a big process, but you just understand that whenever the energy is required from this molecule, then this particular phosphate will get released. Once it's released, it will be again converted to ADP. And when this bond is broken down, then 36 kilocalories of energy is released by one particular molecule. So it's a huge amount of energy is released from this. And this is what is happening when the phosphate molecule bond is breaking down from this. So that is what happens with the light phase. Have you understood this part?
Yes, miss.
Okay. So this much is important for the light phase right now. Okay. And the dark phase is a very simple process. In this, whatever glucose is formed with this reaction, that glucose has to be converted into starch. And this happens in the dark phase. Okay. So the whole glucose, whatever, because listen, it is not like that it will wait for this one reaction to end, then only the dark phase will activate it. They both work simultaneously, whatever is happening in this organelle. So when the light phase is taking place, then it's like a million part of the second. In that much duration only, the dark phase will also be activated and it will continue the reaction as soon as possible, because the glucose is very highly soluble sugar. So once it is formed, it has to be converted into starch. Okay. So now, once you are you have understood this, then see that you asked me that whatever starch is formed or glucose is formed, where it goes, what is happening to it. Now, as we know that this particular process is happening in the leaf, and in last time we did studied the structure of leaf too. Am I right? We studied.
Yes, miss.
Yes, ma'am.
Structure of leaf. Yes. I think I should have that diagram with me. Yes, it is there. So I need to draw. So we have this leaf, and we have this palisade tissue, spongy tissue. So what is happening over here? That whenever the CO2 is diffused inside the cell, it is based on the concentration, because the CO2 concentration in the environment is more as compared to the CO2 in the leaf. So the CO2 is getting diffused from its higher concentration to its lower concentration. Okay. So it enters over here, it performs the light reaction, it performs the dark reaction, okay, and some of the starch will be stored over here in these cells only, and all these intercellular spaces, it will be stored, okay, but majority of it, this starch, whatever is formed, it will be translocated. Okay, so this theory is called translocation of food. Okay, it will be transported to other parts like stem, branches, okay, roots. Okay, so this is how it should be translocated, whatever is formed. And if the plant is flowering or fruiting, then to the fruits, okay, flowers, all of them will get the starch prepared by the leaves. So now you have understood whatever is prepared, where it is going?
Yes, miss. Miss, okay. But what's the main function of the dark phase? Means what happens mainly in the dark phase?
What happens in the dark phase is this, that means, see, the CO2 and water molecule, all, you know, these two molecules are being utilized in the light phase only. Okay. So whatever is they are utilizing, they are ready to prepare the glucose. Once the glucose is prepared, it has to be converted into starch. Now you are asking me, see, you are having NADP, you are having ADP. From where it is coming? It is coming from somewhere here. Okay, it is coming from the dark phase. It is present in the stroma. So stroma is providing NADP and ADP to the light phase actually for the preparation of glucose. Now you have understood?
Okay, miss.
Okay. So, yes, ma'am. I'm not going in much detail because it is a very complex reaction, dear. See, if you go, if you want to know a little bit more about this, then you will understand that this light phase is also a cyclic, non-cyclic. That much detail has to be understood. Then what is happening in the cyclic, how many molecules are formed. It's a big math-like process. The reaction is a little bit towards the math. There is a lot of calculation with this. So that is why I'm not detailing you with the reaction, because it's a very hectic one to understand. So let's understand this, that whatever NADP and ADP you are getting, it is obtained from the stroma. It is present over there and it comes over here just for the splitting of H2O. Now is it clear to you?
Yes, miss. Yes, miss. Thank you, miss.
Okay. So now
yes,
the
ma'am.
Okay, fine, good. So starch is being translocated, and this translocation theory is there. So you must have had in food potatoes, onions, okay, garlic, sweet potatoes, all these, whatever food you are having, basically below the ground, if it is growing, I think you must be knowing how the potatoes, onion, garlic are growing. Am I right?
Yes.
You are aware of, they are below the ground. So
yes,
it is nothing but it's a starch which is being stored in roots, and in turn it takes the form of potato, onion, garlic, sweet potato. You go for the numerous number, turmeric or ginger, anything, take n number of vegetables. All they are nothing but whatever the starch is prepared by the plant, it is stored in that particular part of the tree, and that stored food is taking the form of your vegetables. Now, is it clear what is happening with the starch?
Yes, miss.
Because excess, huge amount of starch is prepared. That's why all vegetables, and if it is on the above the ground, then fruits are formed just because of the formation of starch. The pulp you are having from the fruit, it is nothing but the formation of starch, and it is converted into then next other forms like endosperm and all that. So this is what is happening with the starch prepared by the dark phase of photosynthesis. Got it?
Yes, miss.
Okay. So if this much is clear, then process of photosynthesis is this. Not more than that is required for you right now. So do understand this. We will proceed for the next one. Is that? So let's see that once this is formed, what are the adaptations of leaf? Adaptation of leaf are there to help the process of photosynthesis, because it is the organelle, it is the organ which is responsible for the major process of photosynthesis. Then it has to adapt itself, it has to make itself a something which is which can allow the major maximum amount of photosynthesis at a given number of time. So let's see that first one is its surface area. I think in chemistry you must be reading this, that if the surface area increases, the activity of reaction also increases, or the speed of reaction increases. Do you read this?
Yes, miss.
Yes, ma'am. We have read this in class 9 in observations part.
Yes, true. So surface area plays a very important role. That's why the leaf has to be, if you watch the plants around you, the leaves have a good surface area, and it should be flat, it should be clearly visible for the clearly available for the sunlight to. Large surface area, more photosynthesis. But now do understand this, whatever we are understanding, these adaptation, it's general for all the plants. And if you go for the plants like, I think you must have studied about hydrophytes. Do you understand this? Xerophytes. Have you been introduced to these terms?
What about this?
Okay. So understand this. If we go, there are types of plants too. Okay. So phytes means nothing but plants. And if they live in water, if they live in desert. Okay. So desertic plants, water plants, and there are a lot of categories for this. So it is this particular thing will change with the respect to the type of plant. But it's a general thing what you are studying right now for each and every plant right now. That surface area has to be properly available. It should be properly placed for the process of photosynthesis. Large surface area, huge photosynthesis can occur. Okay. So that you will understand. Let me come up with the other adaptations too. So now you are clear with this? Hydrophytes, xerophytes?
Yes, miss.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
It's a type. You must have studied in your social studies that tropical regions, temperate regions. So environment plays a key factor over there. Okay. So the plants plants in the tropical region and temperate region are also different. So this thing will also are different for those plants. But Nick, that is what you have to understand right now, that surface area is required for the process of photosynthesis. Now, because second one is leaf arrangement. How the leaf is arranged. Okay. Leaf arrangement. Basically, when you see that if you draw the plant, then you will draw the leaf like this. Okay. It should be a little bit tilted and it should be towards above, on the above surface of the ground. It should not be down. Okay. If it is down, then the problem is there. Photosynthesis cannot take place easily. It will create a problem. So it should be on the angular section like this. Understood? So arrangement of leaf is very important. Then we should go for this, I think, cuticle and epidermis. So, and the one which is important is upper epidermis. Okay. So we did study the structure of leaf, and what do you mean by cuticle is that the upper layer of the leaf is covered with a wax-like layer, and that is called cuticle. The stomata are not covered with the cuticle. Do remember that. So whenever you draw, it should not be in continuation. Wherever the stomata is there, you have to leave the cuticle over there only. Okay. So upper epidermis, and this cuticle is transparent in nature. Word you must have heard about it, because our nails are also covered with the cuticle. It's a wax-like polymer. Okay. And it is transparent. First of all, that is also very important, that it is transparent. And this upper epidermis is also transparent. Okay. That's why it allows the sunlight to pass through it. Okay. So here you have a lot of palisade which is having chloroplast. So whenever you are drawing chloroplast, it should not be in the upper epidermis. The chloroplast is placed in the palisade tissues only. Understood now?
Yes, Yes, miss.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So cuticle and upper epidermis. Cuticle is a wax-like layer. It's and upper epidermis, both of them should remain transparent so that it allows the sunlight to pass through it. And this is layer is responsible for the shiny texture of the leaf. You can see the leaves, some of the leaves are very much shiny in nature. Okay, so it's just, and it you can see that leaf have two portions, upper and lower. So upper one will be shiny and the lower one is not that shiny. It is somewhere matte finish, something like that you can see. So you can see the difference with the upper and the lower region. So that is what is the requirement for the upper epidermis. Then another one is number of stomata. Okay. Now, just understand this, that in the leaf, suppose if it is a dicot plant, dicot plant, then the number of stomata on upper epidermis and lower epidermis, okay, upper have less while lower will have more. Okay. And if it is monocots, then both of them all have almost same number. Okay. And if you go for these hydrophytes, then they have stomata only in upper epidermis. Lower epidermis doesn't have the stomata. So there is a difference. Okay. In type, if you go for the types of plant, this particular adaptation will change for each and every plant. Okay. So why they are less in number on the upper epidermis and why they are more? Because stomata is the one which allows the diffusion of CO2 and water molecules. So you will ask, you may ask me that it should be more on the upper region. But there are some other reactions also occurring with this. And to control all these things, the number is like this. On the upper, it is less, and in lower, it is more. Is it clear now? This part you don't have to remember. It's just an extra thing I make you to understand to compare the types of plants. Is it clear to you?
Yes, miss.
Okay. So let's go for the another one. Is that the thinness of leaves? If it is thin, if the leaf is thin, then the cells are nearby each other, okay? And diffusion is little bit much more easier in the thin leaves, okay? So leaf has to be thin, because if it is thick, that means it has stored a lot of starch in it. If lot of starch is being stored, the starch is, I think you must be aware that starch is not soluble in water. So if starch is there, then water diffusion is little bit difficult. Understood?
Yes, miss.
Okay. So that is why thinness of leaves is very important. Whatever food they are preparing, it should be translocated to other parts. It should not be stored over there. It should store, but it should store whatever is required, not more than that. Okay. So thinness of leaves is also very important. Then you should have chloroplast also. And let me use the word living chloroplast. They should not be dead. Okay. Dead. Not useful at all. So chloroplast is also playing a key factor for this. And another one is extensive venation. That means if the leaves have a huge number of venation like this, then it is very much connected to each and every cell, and yes, it is
a bit up.
Yes, pardon.
Miss, please slide your paper a bit up. Miss, it's not.
Yeah. Okay. Now is it clear to you?
Yes.
Okay. So extensive venation is also the will be helpful for the photosynthesis, because whatever reactions are going on, they should be easily, whatever is being prepared or whatever is required, the more it is venated, then the things are easy to pass on to each and every cell. So venation is also important for this. That is how the leaf adapts itself for the process of photosynthesis. You can observe, there are a lot of experiments given in your textbook. And if you go, whenever the school will start, you have a lab and you have all the apparatus for it, where you can see all these things to understand. But some of the experiments you can do at your home only, that why the chloroplast is required. I think you, if you have a small plant which requires sunlight, and you just bring that plant inside your house, then after a while the leaves will turn pale, the green color is lost. Okay, that means the chloroplast is dead. And if you have plants at your home, your mother must be doing that. She will be picking it up and showing little bit of sunlight to them in a week or 10 days.
Yes, miss.
Okay, so if they are introduced to the sunlight for a while, then also it is enough for them to survive. Okay, the one which are the indoor plants. But the one which lives in the outdoor, the one which requires the sunlight more, if you bring them inside, then they will die. The leaf will turn colorless and then they will die. Okay. And for all these number of stomata, surface area, you can observe this around you only. You must have seen that in summer, if it is too hot and the days are too dry, then what happens that leaves of the plant gets twisted. They just turn themselves up like this. Have you seen them?
Ma'am, to avoid transpiration.
Yes, to avoid transpiration, to protect themselves. And because the summer days are very bright, they have the sunlight is too harsh. So what they will do, that if more sunlight will enter, then also the chloroplast will die. You know that? If they, whatever the requirement. Yes. So to avoid transpiration, to protect the chloroplast, what they will do is, nothing but they will either twist themselves, or they will just fall. This angular region, this angle will not be there. They will just fall down like this. Okay. So when you water them, then only they will come up. All these things you can observe in your daily life. There is no need to go to the lab for everything. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And starch also you can observe. It's a very simple experiment. I think in class 4 or 5, your teacher must have shown you that if you put the drops of iodine, then the starch will turn blue. So if you want to see that if the leaf is having starch in it or not, just bring some little bit of tincture iodine from the store. And just you can do that experiment at your home. Understood?
Yes, miss.
Okay. So it's a very simple thing. The experiments given in your textbook are very simple. Just go through them. I don't think they are very much difficult to understand and difficult to perform even. You can have some in what we use nowadays, these words, jugaad, at your home, and you can perform all these experiments at your home. So let's see. These adaptation of leaf we have observed. Now see what is happening. This that factors which is affecting photosynthesis. Okay, I am writing along with this so that we will have a little bit of comparison also. Is it okay for you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So factors affecting photosynthesis is, first is light intensity, the one which we have discussed right now, that huge amount of light is also not required. And let me say this, that in the morning time, I think sun rises in the West Bengal a little bit earlier. Okay, so if we take that at 6 o'clock, the light is available. Okay, till in the days of summers, if we say till 10 o'clock, it's okay. Okay, 11 o'clock, it will work, but it is a bit harsh. Okay, so light intensity till here is utilized by plants, then the leaf will start protecting themselves. The chloroplast will protect itself. Okay, so that is also a different process in the plants to protect itself from the light intensity, harsh intensity. Okay, so it is a very important factor which is affecting the process of photosynthesis. Now see, we are placing street lights near the trees. You must have seen. Okay, street lights are placed near the trees because roads are like that only in our city, and street lights are almost somewhere near the trees. So what they are doing, they are disturbing the photosynthesis process of the trees. And that's why you must have observed, I don't know you have observed or not, or you must have heard from your elders that this is not the flowering season, but still this particular tree is flowering. Have you heard this?
Yes, ma'am. Sometimes we hear.
Yes, ma'am. Sometimes I have heard from my parents also.
Yes. So do observe around you only, because biology is like that only. You can see everything around you, the disturbance also, the good things also you can see. So if, because the photosynthesis is getting disturbed, the flowering, the months of the flowering or the timing of the flowering is also getting disturbed, because the plants get confused with the sunlight and the street light, because most of the street lights are yellow, halogen. Okay, so they get confused with this two part with the sometimes for the photosynthesis, and light and dark reaction just go wrong with that. Okay, and because at night these light and dark reactions should not be there. At night, these light and dark phase should not be there, because sunlight is not there at night, then the process of photosynthesis will not occur. But what happens? We provide the artificial light to them, and this process is continued at night also. That's why some of the trees undergo the change in the flowering too. Okay? Is it clear now?
Yes, miss.
Okay. And you must have seen that as suppose the tree is very tall, okay, and the light, street light is not that tall, it falls on the lower portion of the plant, then also you can see the coloration of the leaves. If you watch very carefully, then the difference in the colors of the leaves will also be there, because the one which is exposed to the light at night, they will be having different type of color, and the one not exposed at night, they are also, they will show a different color. So light intensity plays a very important role in the photosynthesis. You have a I think graph in your textbook regarding light intensity. Is it there?
Yes, ma'am, it's there.
Okay. Just see it. It's very easy to understand that graph.
So it gets stabilized at a point.
Yes, it stabilizes. It stops. It doesn't utilize as much amount of light from the environment. Okay. So next one, this one, light intensity. Then we go for CO2 concentration. Okay. CO2 concentration, that in environment, if CO2 increases, then what happens? I think you are much more aware about the greenhouse effect. Are you aware of that?
Yes, miss. Yes, miss.
Okay. Greenhouse effect. What happens because CO2 increases? Not only CO2, the gases which are having carbon in its composition, they are also playing an important role in greenhouse effect. And this CO2 concentration, if increases, definitely the photosynthesis process will increase with it. Okay, but that is also to some extent. After that extent, it will get stabilized, like the light intensity only. For that also, the graph must be there in your textbook. See, so if 0.02 concentration is there, then the photosynthesis percentage, if 0.05 percent of CO2 is there, then see the photosynthesis also stabilized somewhere in 0 to 0.05, something like that is there?
Yes, yes.
Okay, so it definitely it increases with the CO2. As CO2 increases, photosynthesis process will also increase, but it will get stabilized, it will get stagnant at some point. Okay, after that, much more CO2 is also not good for the plant. Okay, then we studied about temperature. It is also a very important factor. Okay, so definitely a temperature plays that you are aware that seasons plays the key role in the life of a tree. That's why we have that leaf falls, autumn, spring season. So temperature changes with these seasons, and you can see the life of tree also changes with it. The new leaves are coming. New leaves are much more active when they are performing photosynthesis as compared to the older ones. So temperature is a very key factor. And in summers, winter, you can see that in summer, the leaf will start protecting themselves by turning or by twisting. So temperature is also very much important. Optimum temperature is required for the process of photosynthesis. And it is also based on the geographical location. That means for desertic plants, for xerophytes, the temperature should be higher. Okay, you can't keep them at the lower temperature. Definitely you have some ornamental plants at your home, like cactus and all that. Okay, and bonsais are being prepared from that, bonsai plants. So they will survive at your home also, but they are a different thing. But the temperature in the open ground is plays a very key role for the process of photosynthesis. Is it clear?
Yes, yes.
Okay, fine. Then definitely water, because if the grounds are dry, then it is very much difficult for the plant to survive, because transpiration is a very major process which occurs in the plant, and it is completely connected with the water. Okay, so in that is also you can see with the seasons, or observe at your home only. Just have two plants, don't water one of them and water another one too much. Then also, if you provide lot of water, then also they will die. If no water, then also they will die. You have a tulsi plant at your home?
Yes, miss.
Yes, miss.
Or if you are not having at your home, you must have seen at your neighbors or somewhere, even in the cereals, that is daily soaps, the tulsi plant is very much iconic. Okay, so you must have seen that every member of the house will water it.
Yes, miss.
But that's a pity.
Ma'am, I don't know about that because I don't see that all.
Okay, you don't see that. But if you have tulsi plant at your home, then, and if you have a big family, so then you must have seen that when they are, if they are doing that worshipping and all that, almost out of 10, 8 number of members will have give water to that plant. They will give water to the sun, then they will go water the tulsi plant. Have you seen that?
No, miss, not that much worship is going on.
So
yes, ma'am, not that must, much.
Then you should have the concert. You should have the friends who have the big families. Okay, where 15 to 20 number of members are there. There it is happening. And it's a big pity to that plant, because the tulsi is called mesophyte. It's categorized as mesophyte. And meso means mediocre. Somewhere, I will use the term right now, medium. So if lot of water is provided, then what happens? That tulsi will die, and the family member will think, oh my God, what happened? We provided lot of water, then also it's dying. Then they will provide much amount of water to it. Okay, but it is shouting inside, don't give me that much of water, I am a mesophyte, please. Okay, but people don't understand. So we can't make them, but this is what the fact for the factors affecting in that water is playing a key role. Okay, so this is just a fun fact I would just felt like sharing with you. So that if you see your friends, family, those who are having this type of culture, just make them aware that that plant doesn't require it. Understood?
Yes, miss.
Okay. And this you can see that in rainy season also sometimes tulsi dies, because lot of rain will give it lot of water, and if it is on the open space, then it will die suddenly. Okay. So lot of water is not required. And water is also very much important in the process of photosynthesis, definitely, because transpiration is controlled. Whatever is absorbed by the roots, that should be released with the stomata and all that. Okay, so transpiration factor is very important. Then all these are the factors from the environment. And some of the internal factors are also there, that is chlorophyll. Okay, that is what we said, that chlorophyll, if it is not leaving, if it is dying, then also the plant will show the less amount of photosynthesis. So it should be leaving, it should be active. Okay, so that is also important factor. Then protoplasm. Okay, protoplasm or cytoplasm. These words, I think you must be aware of it.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. They are all interconnected here. That means the protoplasm, the cell should not shrink. They will shrink in dry condition. They should be properly shaped with the help of water. Okay. So shrinking of protoplasm is also a very much key factor for the process of photosynthesis. And structure of leaf is also very important. The how it is being classified on the basis of its structure, that is also a very important part, because plants in the desert have a very thick leaves and they have the jellies in them, stored food in them, and plants on the water, they have the floaty leaves. So structure of leaves is also a very important key factor for the process of photosynthesis. Just go through these chlorophyll, protoplasm and structure of leaf from your textbook. Just read it for yourself. And if you have any doubts, just ask me.
Miss, I was going through this chapter from another book of biology. Miss, so okay. Miss, there were some terms that I didn't understand.
Okay, just pop it out, one of it.
Yes, miss. Etiolation means it's written that when the plant's chlorophyll dies, it undergoes etiolation. Miss, what is the meaning of etiolation?
Etiolation means, now do understand this, that photosynthesis is one process. There is another process called photorespiration. Okay. This is also another process. Now, see, whenever the chlorophyll dies, the plant will not allow it to die as soon as, means it will not allow suddenly that, okay, fine, it is dying, let it die. It is not so. Okay. So, there is a process called photorespiration, and this respiration process is not the way we respire. It's something little bit different. And when this process is means continued or started in the plant, that it means it will reduce the effect of the factors on particular organelle which is dying. Okay. Attenuation, that means when the leaf twists or just bend down from its angle, okay, from its angle. So it will reduce the effects of these factors which is affecting that chlorophyll, and that process is called attenuation. Is it clear?
Factors affecting the chlorophyll means?
Suppose if it is light is affecting chlorophyll, huge amount of light, then it will start twisting. If it is too much hot and transpiration rate is being increased, the water is being lost from the plants. So it will make the leaf to bend down. Okay. So that thing, can you see this?
Okay, no, miss, your video is paused.
Is it yes. Clear now? Okay. So, so what happens is that if transpiration is rate is being increased due to the temperature. Okay, if temperature is too hot, then huge amount of transpiration will occur. And if this transpiration is too much, the leaves are not allowed to place like this on the plant. They will just make them fall down from that particular angle. And that process is called attenuation. I think this is the word.
No, miss, not that. Miss, etiolation, etiolation, L.
Okay, so just read out the spelling for me.
Etiolation.
Okay, fine. Etiolation. What I was teaching was attenuation. Okay, so just understand this one also. That it in
ma'am, your video is paused again.
Yes, miss.
Is it paused? Why is it so? Is it paused right now?
Yes, miss.
Yes, ma'am.
Why is it? I don't understand the technology much.
For me, ma'am, switch off your video once and then again turn it on.
Okay, fine. Let me do that. And from where I can do that?
Ma'am, that start video option is there now.
Okay.
And then stop video, it will be typed there.
Okay. Let me see. Am I back?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. So, successfully done. Okay. So, etiolation. Okay, fine. It is related to something to the light beta. Okay. So, if light is, if the chlorophyll is dying, suppose if chlorophyll is not leaving, it dies, then some of the plants have the capability to process the important physiological processes in them in the absence of light, and that process is called etiolation. That process is called etiolation. Okay, so that is what you have to understand. Is it clear?
Yes, yes.
Okay, so till here we will do today, and you asked me for the extra class, right?
Yes, miss.
Okay, I am just working on that. Let's see how we will plan. And can you give me the time where I can plan it?
Miss, among the 7 days, Saturday and Sunday, I am free completely.
Okay, you are free. And the one
it needs to be thought after 7 days.
Okay, Saturday and Sundays are free for you. Okay.
Yes,
and ma'am, just the opposite for me.
Okay, for you Saturday and Sunday is completely busy.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. If it is okay for you, if I plan a little bit late in the evening, if it is like that?
Okay, miss. No problem.
Okay,
ma'am, if you want to plan, ma'am, then please plan after 6 or 7. Ma'am, if after 7, then it will be better. Because every day...
Miss, if after 7, then other than Tuesday and Wednesday, means I have other tuitions, miss.
Okay, Tuesday and Wednesday. Fine. So Tuesday, Wednesday, Saturday and Sundays has to be aborted.
Ma'am, my 7 o'clock Monday, Wednesday and Friday. I'm having my science and maths class.
Okay, fine. So let me work out on this, how we will be planning it. Okay.
Udayan.
Yes.
We can have the class on the previous timetable, like on Friday 2:30.
Yeah, and the previous schedule, it was good.
Yes, previous one was good.
Previous one was good. Okay, fine. Friday 2:30. In the afternoon, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, if I will be planning, I will let you know by messaging you. And just do a favor to me that you have your chapters with you. What chapters you have completed till now, just let me know that. Cell is done?
Yes, miss. First three are done.
Yes, miss. First three are done.
first three, structure of chromosome, cell cycle, and genetics. All these yes, three ma'am. Are done. Okay, and yes, we ma'am. Have started with the photosynthesis. Am I right?
Yes, miss.
Yes, miss.
Okay, fine. And you have exams in the September?
Yes, miss.
Maybe.
Maybe.
Yes, miss. I am having exams.
Okay, just do one thing. Write the name of your school and write down the syllabus you have in your exams in this another
month.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, if your school is providing it, then it's not provided yet, then also it's okay.
Ma'am, my school has not provided the syllabus yet.
Yes. Yes, okay, ma'am. So let's see. Let's wait for it. No need to worry. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay. So have a good day.
Okay, miss. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, goodbye.